minute. Here we go. L'shem yikud kudashabri hu ushinate bi ilu ar imu laihe jem yuki bevoki biyuda shalom b'shem kozriel kolam amen. This is Parsha Korach. And it's got multiple levels of teaching in the picture. And so one way to understand this is the idea that this is a family a feud that they try to manipulate people with. So Korach is a first cousin of Moses and Aaron, okay? His first cousin, and Miriam, his first cousin, okay? And his initial complaint was Amram, the father of Moses and Aaron and Miriam, had first choice, got a double portion, and his father was the second born, Yitzhar, and then he should have been the high priest instead of Elizaphan. Not the high priest. He should have been the tribal leader, prince, instead of Elizaphan. So we had this kind of idea of how it should be. And he uses a certain amount of, what I'm going to say, political correctness. We're all a democracy. All of Israel is equal. And all that sounds good, except it's not accurate. Now, what's not accurate about it is that, yes, everyone's holy, but some people are more spiritually mature than others. One, and two, God actually selected Moses and Aaron and actually Miriam to be leaders here. That's who got selected. And it isn't a question of a democratic election or family formalities. So the bigger teaching is, yeah, we're all equal, we're all holy, okay, but there is, for the moment, a spiritual hierarchy. And you're part of the Levites. The Levites replaced the firstborn Reubenites, and that's the way it is. So this is really a core conflict, but again, got used with the cleverness of spiritual correctness, so to speak, that actually got misused and got people to kind of go against Moses and Aaron in the picture. And that's kind of the essence of it. Now, there's another level of the story, which is called karma. So it said that Moses was the reincarnation of Abel and Korach was the reincarnation of Cain, number one. So, and that battle's still going on. Now, people have a chance to resolve this, okay? Jethro also was an incarnation of Cain, but he and Moses came to peace, okay? And the other reincarnation was the Egyptian slave master who was beating the Jewish portion, and he was the incarnation of Cain. And again, Moses is able to say a holy word and he died. So this battle is going on three different levels of three different soul combinations here. So that's pretty interesting to kind of see in the bigger picture of what's going on. Now, Korach is really refusing to cooperate, saying we're all equal, you have no right to be the leader. So he's challenging the leader. Well, Moses, in his humility, is you're not going against me, you're going against God. This was our destiny. And there is this karma playing out. We use the word midad keneged midad, which is measure for measure. So then we begin to get the metaphors of what's going on. So the challenge here is that Korach and his people don't want to accept the leadership of Moses. Korach wants to be the chief. And one of the things that gets him in trouble is he found a lot of wealth that Joseph had buried, so he was very wealthy and influential. Okay. But the principle is, I have, therefore I am. That's not a very good principle. Okay. It's like, and not only that, I have, therefore I want more. So this is a principle in fortune that we see being in operation today by the people trying to kind of control the world. I have, therefore I want more. So Korach, like, well, what will happen today, gets defeated using this principle. Now, there is a principle that we are to take. So that's how the whole Parsha starts, with the first word of Vayelech, to take. But then we're to receive in order to share. That's the real principle. And then the middle column, okay, because you're taking to the left and then sharing to the right, is the middle column is the pace of liberation, where this is all integrated. Okay, Zion Pen and Nukva, we integrate the middle column. Korach didn't want to do that. Korach was the Egyptian thing. I take. I'm ego, I take. And I ignore really the destiny that's unfolded, that, hey, I got a pretty good deal. I'm in the tribe of Levite. I'm very wealthy because of what I found as a result of Joseph's treasures. But that wasn't enough for him, okay? So, and he wanted to stay only in the left column to receive for self alone. So Moses is seeing this whole thing playing out, the whole karmic thing playing out, and he challenges them, a spiritual challenge. The winner lives, the loser dies. That's what we're talking about. That's what happened. So Moses makes a prayer that they should not receive the blessings of their offering, which means fire, means getting burned up. So there's 250 people of the tribe of Reuven and Kohath's tribe, also Levite, and Kohath, but it's, okay. So they gather, and then God speaks to Moses and said, get away from Korach and his whole family now. And so Korach and some elements of Reuven, Datan and Avram, stay where they are, and the earth opens up and they're swallowed. And they have a revelation at that point. Oh, as they're going down into the depths, Moses was right, he was in the truth. Now that being said, that takes us to another level of awareness here, is that destiny is there. Midah keneged midah. So what did Cain do? Cain and Abel, we go back, is it Cain buried Abel in the earth. And now just the opposite is happening. Moses, as a reincarnation of Abel, under God's direction, buries Korach, the reincarnation of Cain, in the earth. So the earth is receiving, but of course the earth gives back by creating nature, right? So we now have a karmic fulfillment, midad keneged midad, and then fire comes out from the ark and burns up the 250 people making their offering, so the offering is not received. Now, what also happens here is that the people still don't believe what's going on. There were doubts created in their mind. So Moses said, okay, we got our 12 tribes, and we'll put our staffs here, and Aaron will put his staff in. Now, let's see what happens. And so after 2 days, Aaron's staff grows flowers and fruit, and it's clear God has chosen Moses and Aaron to do this work. Now here's the interesting thing, is that Korach wasn't totally wrong. He just wasn't getting the total picture, because at the end of this era, time, Korach will blossom, and actually it said he'll be the high priest, but then everybody will get the deeper truth. And at that point, everybody will be more spiritually equal. So he was there, but not there. So we have a principle here in the Torah that arguing for the sake of God is a good principle. It's good to do, and it stays. And both become true, have elements of the truth. And that's called Shem Shemayim, arguing for the sake of God. So the principle here, the message here is Medad Keneged Medad, being completed in the complications of the different karmas, Moses and Aaron following the will of God, following their destiny, the illusion of spiritual harmony, a spiritual hierarchy, so people can have their leadership, and the power of God intervening so the destiny can be unfolded. And Israel and all people will reach their highest spiritual destiny. So may everybody be blessed with the teachings of this, and may everyone actually be humbled by the awesomeness of how destiny unfolds. And one other point, which is key to the whole story, not only did Korach and his whole family and his children, except several of them who renounced and their descendants actually one of them was Samuel, the great prophet Samuel. But even the babies went into the earth. So how could that be? Well, we don't really have any good explanation, except people come and they have their karmas and they get played out and they disappear. But the deeper teaching is the Baal Shem Tov teaching, which is once you've gained wisdom and Torah knowledge, we return to simple faith. We really don't have the answers of these things. Why do the babies? Well, I mean, they're innocent, right? The answer is simple faith in whatever God does for the best. And this is really beyond, most things are beyond our understanding. So the kind of final teaching here is the importance of simple faith, no matter how sophisticated we are spiritually, Kabbalistically, it comes down to the simple faith that whatever God does is for the best. May everyone appreciate these teachings. Shalom, shalom, shalom.